Hello, hello! Welcome back to Ivana Snoshkvai. Today I will answer two main questions. I will explain to you monthly expenses in Norway and I will answer the question how much money do you need when you move to Norway. Let's start! Let's start with the first one. The monthly expenses in Norway can, of course, they will vary, depends on many things and conditions, but I try to calculate the minimum that you need to have, and I have two options for you. The minimal amount per month that you need if you live in Oslo, it is starts from 10,000 kroners and could be even 14,000 kroners. And let's look what are these two options and why it is this 4,000 kroners a month difference between them. So if you think about 10,000 Norwegian kroners that you need to have monthly in Norway, they will cover for you in Oslo. Public transport will be included in this monthly 795 kroners. So this is one thing that you need. Then also you will need to buy a SIM card. I found that the cheapest one, it is one call. And I think that you still need to have some internet. So including 3 gigabytes of the internet, the monthly cost will be 235 Norwegian kroners. And this is not a paid advertisement or something. This is what I found on the internet. Something that is the cheapest one. Then also if we think what else do you need? Of course you need to have a food. I try to estimate the main products that every person needs to have. And of course it depends on what type of meat you eat or maybe you don't eat. So it's a lot of different things, but in this, in 3,000 Norwegian kroners a month, I didn't include any alcohol at all. So it's like the major food that we typically eat is like bread, eggs, some frozen chicken because it's cheaper, it's fresh vegetables. It's a huge pack of fries, it is also pasta included, fruits, milk, frozen vegetables because they cost cheaper. So all of that together, it's about 3,000 Norwegian kroners. Of course, you could try to fit a bit less, but you need to count for that amount of money. And then, of course, so we included already transportation, we said about SIM card, we said about food, and I don't include any clothes because I assume that you come here with some clothes and you can wait a couple of months with your salary, save a bit of money, and then buy your clothes. So the last one, it is accommodation. And this is actually the point where you have this version 1 and version 2 prices, where it's 10,000 and 14,000 a month. The difference is that the cheaper option, it's when you rent a room and you share the bathroom, you share the living room, you share the kitchen, and you have only a small tiny room for yourself where you can sleep and do some stuff. And being honest, in Oslo, I've checked many different options and the price is actually quite close to what we have here in Jovik. So I wouldn't count that much that it will change hugely around the Norway. And it was 5,000 kroners, the approximate price, like average price that I was able to find. The cheapest one, it was 4,200 kroners in Oslo. So, but I counted 5,000 just to be sure that you are able to find some room that is okay for living. So if you go with this option, then all of that together brings you to 10,000 kroners a month. But if we talk about another option where you say that it's not acceptable for you to share the living room, to share the kitchen and to share the bathroom, so and you want to have an apartment, even small one, but apartment, here it comes, I found that you can find somewhere like 9,000 kroners, you can find a reasonable price and reasonable apartment in Oslo. The cheapest one that I've seen, it was about 8,200, 8,500, but the problem is that it wasn't included internet, it wasn't included electricity or water, so that's why here 9,000, I think it's much better option if you have all included in your price. So if in room you also, the price that I said, 5,000 kroners, it also include everything like internet, electricity, payments, so you are safe there. And all of these options that I told you, they are furnished because you don't want to spend money on that. So this is kind of answering the first question, how much per month you need if you don't go to eat somewhere out, if you don't drink alcohol. So this money should be enough. And now we can go to the second question, because renting an apartment or renting a room, it comes with some specific obligations in Norway, and therefore it affects you, this choice will affect how much money you actually need when you move to Norway. And imagine that you move to Oslo. First of all, when you come to Norway, you will come to the airport and you need to get to the city, right? So I checked how much does it cost. So you need to have 110 Norwegian kroners to buy a ticket to come from airport to Oslo center. Then also, imagine that when you will be searching your room or apartment, in Norway we also have a deposit. So it's kind of money that you put into bank account for the accommodation that will be used by those who are renting to you your room or apartment. You can use this money if you damage something in the apartment. This money, it's not kind of, you put them once in the common shared bank account between you and the person who is renting your apartment, and you will get it back when you move out from this room or apartment. And of course, the choice whether you are willing to rent the room or apartment will significantly increase amount of money that you need to have at the very beginning when you move to Norway. Because if you imagine that you rent a room for 5,000 kroners, and I found, of course, it could be 1 month deposit, it can be 2 months deposit, and in some cases it can be just a number that is written down by a person. So I found for 5,000 kroners a reasonable room with everything included, and deposit is 7,500 Norwegian kroners. So I included this in this how much money do you need when you just move to Norway. But when we talked about the apartment on the other side, in the apartment you were paying 9,000 kroners a month, and then the person wanted to have 2 months deposit, so it comes to 18,000 kroners deposit. So it means that in addition to the ticket for train from airport to come into Oslo, you need to have this money. And of course, you will not pay them when you are here, you will pay them from home before you come here. But you need to account for those money. And so version one is renting a room where you need to have depositum, could be 7,500 or 10,000, and then apartment where it can be 27,000 kroners. So you can feel already right the vibe to that apartment, it's a bit harder to get if you don't have enough money. So then when you decided that you move to Norway, at the very beginning you need to have for 1 month of life here, and to cover these expenses, deposit and the transportation from the airport all together, for the first option you will need to have 18,000 Norwegian kroners, and for the second option 33,000 Norwegian kroners. And then you can add on every single month from the monthly expenses that I just presented before. So all of this, it describes you how much money do you need. Of course, if you want to spend on some extra things, you will need to have even more money. And for you also to understand, this is kind of critical, that before you move to Norway, you will sign a contract with, it could be a private person who is renting to your apartment, or it could be a company who does this. Please be careful, read the contract, because in some cases it can be stated that when you rent in the contract, it can state that you cannot change the apartment. You have to stay in this apartment, for example, for 9 months before you can change apartment. and it could be also, it's called oppsigelse. So if, for example, you want to change apartment and you don't want to live here anymore, it could be in the contract written down that you have to say it 3 months in advance. So also check this. In some cases, I've seen the company who was renting an apartment for the year where it was written down in the contract that the first 9 months you cannot change the apartment. You have to live there for 9 months. So I hope you understood this point of view, and please make sure to check this information in your contract before signing anything. This is all from me for today. I hope you find it useful. And please don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, write your questions in the comment. And I shared the link to defin.no with you, so you can also go there and check apartments for yourself. Thank you very much for staying until the end, and see you next time. Bye!